If you, like me, you use pen and paper for note taking, then you know the frustrations of not being able to search your notes, not being able to merge with the stuff that you've written on your laptop. You have to retype everything, and it's a nightmare. But if you're stubborn like me, then you don't want to give it up. Then I'll show you how I digitize my notes so I can take everything I've written on pen and paper, make it searchable in the computer, and I will show you with my Lamy and Neolab pen. This is not sponsored. I bought it myself. I think it's worth the investment. So let me show you how it works. So first, how does a smart pen even work? There are basically three components. One is, of course, the smart pen. So this one, the one I got looks like this. If you know Lamy, this is the Safari pen. The second component is the smart notebook. And the third one is an app on your phone or on your iPad. And with these three things, you're going to be able to digitize your notes. First, the pen itself. I got the Lamy Neolab pen. There are other types. I like this one because it looks good. I have Lamy pens as well. And it's just like any other pen. It comes with a ballpoint nib that once you finish using, they're pretty standard, so you can get refills on them. You can get different colors if you like. The smart part of it is that it has this camera sensor on it. So as you write, it's going to be able to pick up what you're writing. And it comes with an inbuilt battery, so you can charge it with a micro USB. Very simple, there's a power button on the back. You just press on it and then it should turn on. There's a LED here that changes color. If you need to charge it, it'll turn reddish. If you're connected to Bluetooth, I think it'll turn green. So that's the smart pen. Then you can't just write it on anything. You have to get the Neo Smart Pen notebook. The smart notebook, while you can't really see it, they have what's called N codes on them. So basically just little dots that tell the pen and the app where it is on the page that the pen is writing on. And so you have to get the Neo Smart Pen notebooks, and they look pretty good. I got the Lamy Neolab collaboration notebook. Looks like a moleskin. It's gridded, which is great because I don't know about you. If notebooks are lined, I feel like my thinking is restricted. I don't know if this is just me or anyone else feels this way. If you do, please let me know in the comments so I know I'm not crazy. And then I got these IdeaPad minis because I take note Zettelkasten style. If you don't know what it is, oh my god, it might just change your life. I did another video on what is Zettelkasten, you know, the simple explanation of how it works and how you can get started. And please check it out. It really is life-changing for me. I wish I started doing it when I was a teen. Anyway, so I took this IdeaPad to take my Zettelkasten notes when I want to write them by hand. Then once you've got the pen, the notepad, you can then check the pairing and all of your notes digitized on your iPad or iPhone or, you know, Android. So mobile devices. Let me show you how it works. Okay, so you open Neo Studio and it will automatically find the pen that you're looking for. Press connect. And the pen has been connected. So now if you press on the first page, it will recognize that it's the first page of the Neo IdeaPad. So you can say Zettelkasten 310. And the iPad will immediately write that for you. Once you're done, hit the menu button and there'll be quite a few things you can do. The most important one to digitizing our notes is transcribe. That will take whatever we've written into a editable text. And you can remove things, you can, of course, copy and paste. You can also share it in all of the traditional ways that you can do. So I use Obsidian, I just copy and paste. If you want to get fancy, you know, use different colors, change the thickness of your writing, you can also do that in the app. Then you can highlight things. Of course, you can erase things if you no longer think that's relevant. Or I quite like this tool, is to be able to circle the things on the page and then moving them. So if you ever want to reorganize your thoughts, this is a really easy way of doing it and visually seeing how it looks when you move things around. Also, when you hit the mail button, it'll bring up the page already scanned for you and you can just send it to whoever you want. A huge time saver for anyone who needs to send notes around to different people. Now, depending on the notebook that you have, you might have something cool like this, where it's a bookmark to change color and the thickness of the line that you write. And let's say I want to keep this as notes, so I can tap on the line. Let's say I want to then make it longer and make it yellow. I can do this. And so this way you have a controller that's really easy to use when you want to get fancy with your note taking. And of course there are bookmarks where you can add this to favorites, or of course you can share. And on your notepad or on your mobile device, you're going to be able to do all of these things, assign to contact, you know, even print, save files. So this is really a life changer, people. I know I'm geeking out, but this is the most exciting thing that has happened in my note-taking life. I'm going to get the 2022 journal agenda to see how it works with calendar sync, because based on their website, you can also sync things that you write into your physical journal and it will immediately auto-populate an event on your Google Calendar or your iCal. And I think that's the other pain point that I have, so I'm really excited to try that. They haven't sent that yet, so maybe I'll do another video on this if I really like it. And price wise it is an investment. I think this Lamy one was 22,900 yen, Japanese yen, so that's around $250, and it comes with the notebook. I think by itself it's just under $200. I'll put the actual prices here. So it's not cheap, but think about all the time that I'm going to save and all the ideas that I don't have to rehash and or just lose, because the current situation is I have lots of paper notes scattered everywhere around my house. I never revisit them because it's so much work going through them, you know, digitizing them. But as I'm building my personal knowledge management system, my second brain on Obsidian, I really need everything digitized. I don't want to redo work again and again. And so this Zettelkasten notepad is going to be an asset to that. I will do another video on how to implement a Zettelkasten in Obsidian, what the workflow looks like, how the setup is. It's actually really simple. So hopefully if you're interested, check that out. If you want to see what Zettelkasten is, check this video out. The first time I found out about it, I was just mind blown. Why didn't I do this 10 years earlier? So let me know in the comments if you have any other questions about the pen. I'm hoping to use this for a couple of months and then do another video on it. If you found this helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'll be putting out more videos like this and on frameworks and mental models. So I'll see you in the next one. Bye!